Hey guys, once again, welcome back to the brand new video. In this video, we will create a nice and simple modern slideshow animation that is super cool and super easy to create inside of Adobe After Effects. You can also call this video effect or video transition. This is Vikas from Sky9 Motions, and without any further ado, let's jump into the After Effects and get started. Alright, so here we are in Adobe After Effects, and if you are watching this video first time on this channel, please hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos, and also hit the like button for this video. And now let's start by creating a new composition. So click on this new composition button, or you can just go over here and take a new composition, and this is going to be the main composition, so let's call it main. Set the size of this composition 1920 by 1080, frame rate 60, duration make it 5 seconds long, background color maybe black, hit OK. And now we have to take one more composition, that is going to be the media composition where we can drag and drop our image or video file. So just go to composition, take a new composition, and this is going to be the media. So I'm going to call it media, leave the setting as it is, hit OK. And now we need an image or video file for this project, so just go to this project window, right click on that, go to import file and select any video or image file. So in this case I am using this image that I have downloaded from unsplash.com, and I will give you a link in the description so you can download this image for practice and click on import. Now let's drag the image inside of this media composition, and you have to fit this image, so hit S on the keyboard to open this scale property. Let's scale it down a little bit, so I'm going to set the value maybe 65%. Hit P on the keyboard to open this position property. Let's drag the Y position value and set it like this. Alright, now you can go to the main composition, and inside of this main composition we have to import the media composition inside of this main composition just like that. Just go to the end of this animation, hit S on the keyboard to open this scale property, set the scale value maybe 90%, click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on a scale property and lock the scale value as it is at the end of this animation, and go to very first frame of this animation and set the value maybe 120% at very beginning of this animation. And now we will get this smooth animation which is looking perfect. And then we have to apply some effect on this image, so it's very simple. Select the media composition, go to effect and preset. If you don't have this effect and preset, then go to window and check this option effect and preset and search for tint effect. So this is the tint effect. Let's apply the tint on this image and make it black and white just like that. And then go to effect and preset and search for camera lens blur. So this is the camera lens blur. Let's apply the effect on this image just like that. And then go to the effect control, and here we have the blur radius. So I'm going to set the blur radius value maybe 10 and make it like this. After that, we have to add some noise on it, so it's very simple to create. Just go to layer, go to new and take a new solid layer, and this is going to be the noise, so you can call it noise, hit OK. Go to effect and preset and search for fractal noise. So this is the fractal noise effect. Let's apply this on the white solid layer just like that, and then go to effect control, and here we have to do some basic setting. So just go to fractal type and set it to turbulent or dynamic, and set the noise type maybe block, and here we have the contrast and the brightness. So I'm going to set the contrast value maybe 60, brightness maybe negative 60. Perfect. And here we have the complexity, so I'm going to reduce the complexity. Set the value maybe 1.2, which is perfect for me, and open the transform, and here we have the scale, so we have to increase the scale a little bit. So I'm going to set the scale value maybe 200, and here we have the evaluation. So I'm going to use a time expression for the evaluation, so hold alt on the keyboard and click on this stopwatch button to open the expression box for evaluation, and let's type a time expression. So I'm going to type time multiply by 100. Perfect. And we will get this type of continuous animation, which is looking nice. Now you can close the layer. And then we have to blend the noise with the image. So here we have the blending mode. If you don't have the blending mode, you can click on the toggle switches and just go to the mode and change this to add. And then we will get something like this, which is looking very cool. Select both the layers, right click on that, click on pre-compose and check this option, move all attributes into the new composition. And this is going to be the black and white, so I'm going to call it black. Hit OK. And now we have to create a rectangular shape over here. So select the rounded rectangle tool from here, click on fill, set it to solid color, click on stroke and set it to none. Select any fill color, it doesn't really matter. And let's create a rectangular shape just like that. Open the rectangle one, open the rectangle path one, and here we have the size. So click on this button and unlink the width and height. Let's set the width value maybe 1600, height value maybe 800. Let's increase the corner radius. So here we have the roundness. Let's set the value maybe 60. And now it is looking perfect. After that, you can close the shape layer. Select the shape layer and let's set the anchor point in the center of this shape layer. So hold control on the keyboard and just double click on the span behind tool. And now the anchor point is in center. And then we have to align the shape in the center. So it's very simple. Select the shape layer, go to align. If you don't have the align, then go to window and check this option align and click on this align horizontally, click on the align vertically. Basically, you have to set the rectangle in the center. Select the move tool and here we have to use the track mat. So again, if you don't have the track mat, you can click on the toggle switches, change this track mat to alpha mat. After that, we have to animate the shape layer. So select the shape layer, go to 1.5 seconds right over here, hit P on the keyboard to open this position property, lock the position as it is at 1.5 seconds over here, click on this stopwatch button and lock the value as it is. Go to very first frame of this animation and let's drag it down. You can set it in any direction, but I'm going to set the value maybe 1600 in the bottom direction. Select both the keyframes, hit F9 to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor. If your graph editor not looking like this, then right click on that and click on this edit a speed graph. And then hold this point, hold this handle and just drag it like that. And we will get this smooth animation, which is looking perfect. And then go to 1.5 seconds right over here. Open the shape layer. Close the transform, open the contents, open the rectangle one, and here we have the transform rectangle one. Let's open it up and here we have the skew axis. So I'm going to set the skew axis maybe 90 degrees, and here we have the skew. So click on this stopwatch button on the skew and lock the value of a skew as it is at 1.5 seconds. Go to 1 second forward in time, maybe 2.5 seconds over here. Set the skew value maybe 5 and we will get this type of output. Now you can close the shape. Select the shape layer, hit U on the keyboard to open the active keyframes, and here we have these new keyframes. Select these two keyframes, hit F9 on the keyboard to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor, hold this point, hold this handle and just drag it like this and create a nice smooth graph. And then you can close the graph editor. And finally, we will get something like this. Let's close the layer. And then we have to select these two layers. Right click on that, click on pre-compose. And this is gonna be the bottom layer. So I'm gonna call it bottom. Check this option, move all attributes into the new composition, hit OK. Perfect. And now we have to create a duplicate of this bottom layer. So just go to project window, select the bottom composition, hit Ctrl D, right click on this bottom two and click on rename. I'm going to call it top because this is going to be the top layer. So select the top, drag it over here at the top of this layer, just like that. And then open the top layer and here we have the black. So we have to replace the black with the color. So what we have to do, select the black composition, hit Ctrl D, right click on that, click on rename, call it color. hit enter. Just go to very first frame of this animation, select the black composition, hold alt on the keyboard, and let's drag the color and overlap on this black composition. And now you can double click on this color composition, and here we have to do some settings. So select the media and go to effect control, delete the tint effect, delete the camera lens blur, and make it like this. Now we have to do one more thing, just select the noise, and we have to invert the noise for variation. Check this option to invert the noise. Alright, and now we will get something like this. After that, we have to add some text over here. So select the text tool, go to character. If you don't have the character, then go to window and check this option, character. And we have to select our favorite font style. So in this case, I am using this Gotham Ultra font style, which is my personal favorite font style. You can use any font style that you like. Click on this button, Fox Italic. Here we have the size. So let's set the size maybe 500. Click over here and type anything, whatever you want. Just like that. Hit Ctrl A to highlight all, and let's turn off the fill color. So click on this little icon over here and turn off the fill color and turn on the stroke. And here we have the stroke thickness, so you can control the stroke thickness. So in this case, I'm using 3 pixel. Perfect. And we have to align the text in the center. So select the move tool, click on align, align horizontally, align vertically. Now it is looking perfect. And then select the text layer, hold control on the keyboard, and just double click on this pan behind tool to set the anchor point in the center. And then we have to pre-compose the layer. So right click on this text layer, click on pre-compose, and this is going to be the text. So let's call it text 1, because this is the text 1 composition, and we have to animate the text 1. So go to 1.5 seconds right over here, hit P on the keyboard to open this position property, click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on position, go to very first frame, and let's drag it down a bit, set the value maybe 1500. Now select both the keyframe, hit F9 to easy ease them, go to your graph editor, highlight this point, hold this handle and just drag it like this, and create nice and simple smooth curve. Close this graph editor. Now we will get something like this, and we have to add one more text over here. So select the text 1, go to project window. First of all, we have to duplicate the text 1, so hit Ctrl D to duplicate, and now we have the second text. Go to very first frame, and then we have to create one more duplicate for this text 1. So select the text 1, hit Ctrl D in the project panel, and we have to replace the text 1 with the text 2. So it's very simple, hold alt on the keyboard, select text 1 and the text 2, just drag the text 2 over on this text 1, and then you can double click on this text 2, and we have to create a variation on this. So select the text layer, go to character, and this time we have to turn off this stroke and turn on the solid. Let's decrease the size. So I'm gonna set the value maybe 200. You can use any different font style as well. Select the move tool and place the text over here, maybe just like that, and then go to the color tab, and here we will get something like this. Now we have to add some drop shadow on it. So select the text 2, go to effect and preset, and search for drop shadow. So this is the drop shadow effect. Let's apply the drop shadow on the text 2, and here we have to do some settings. So this is the softness. Let's set the softness value maybe 50, opacity maybe 30% or 25%. Now it's looking perfect. And then we have to create a time gap between both the text layers. So it's very simple again. Select the text 2, hit U on the keyboard to open the active keyframes. Go to 15 frame forward in time, select both the keyframes and place it on the 15th frame. And finally, we will get something like this. Perfect. And then you can go to the top section, and then you can go to the main composition. And here we will get something like this. Now we have to do one more thing. Just go to the top composition, select the shape layer 1, hit U on the keyboard to open the active keyframes. Just go to 1.5 seconds on this keyframe, and let's change the skew value. So I'm gonna set the skew value -5, And then you can go to the main composition and you can see what we are getting. Perfect. And then we have to do one more thing. Just go to 1.5 seconds over here, select the top, hit S on the keyboard to open this scale property. Click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on a scale property. Go to 2.5 seconds, maybe 1 second forward in time. And let's set the scale value maybe 90%. Perfect. And select both the keyframes, hit F9 to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor, highlight this point, hold this handle and just drag it like this. Now we will get something like this. After that, we have to add drop shadow effect on the top layer. So select the top composition, go to effect and preset and search for drop shadow. And here we have the drop shadow. Let's apply the drop shadow on the top layer and let's set the softness maybe 100 and opacity maybe 25%, which is looking perfect. And then we will get something like this. Perfect. And now we have to create a time gap between the black and white and the color one. So just open the top composition, select the shape layer, hit P on the keyboard to open the position property. Just go to 15 frame forward in time, highlight these keyframes, just drag it on the 15 frame. And finally, we will get a time delay between both the layers in the main composition, as you can see. And now we have to create a white background for that. So just go to layer, go to new and take a new solid layer. And this is going to be the background. So I'm going to call it busy for the background. Hit OK. Let's place the background layer below the bottom layer. All right. And finally, we have something like this. Perfect. Now you can turn on the motion blur. So click on the toggle switches and turn on the motion blur for each layers. Now you can use any video clip or images instead of the image. So just go to project window. Let's import any video clip. So I'm going to use this video clip for now. Click on import. Simply you have to go on the media composition. You can drag and drop the video clip inside of the media composition. You can hide the visibility of this previous image. Go to main composition and here we go. Perfect. Now let's go to the full screen and let's have a look. Alright, so it's looking awesome and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos and also hit the like button for this video. My name is Vikas and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.